Ian Hudson, SNP MEP. I understand that it's been very successful, this scheme in Aberdeen, the Heat and Power project. What's your own view of the work that's been done there?
Well, we have here a good example of a local authority initiative, a public body taking an initiative and setting up and providing heat and power to their own buildings and saving money as a result, so that the precious financial resources can be focused more directly on providing the services that, in this case, Aberdeen City Council aspires to provide.
And in future, they, as I understand it, would like to go further. Just explain what their expansion plans are and what problems they may face when it comes to European law.
Well, it seems logical in Aberdeen, and it seems logical to me that if the City Council has a building near to a public building of the Health Board or the police or some other public body, that they ought to be able to work together in this initiative to provide heat and power at reasonable cost. But it turns out that there is a European complication in terms of procurement law with this, and I've asked a question of the European Commission to see whether there's any scope for opening up that question and allowing, in these very difficult financial times, public bodies to work together and to provide each other with heat and power in order to focus on their core business of providing services to people.
Do you think you're going to have success with the European Commission? Do you think they might be favourable to this, given, as you're saying, the economic circumstances?
Well, one never knows with the European Commission what the outcome of a query might be, but I would hope that some common sense might prevail and that we might be able to make some progress here, because although at this moment there is a technical issue with procurement regulation coming from here in Brussels, procurement regulation is under review, and I'm raising this now at the request of Councillor Graham Dixon, who brought it to my attention in Aberdeen, to see whether we can perhaps improve a situation which may even be a matter of unintended consequence. It's not something where local authorities want to set up businesses to compete with the privately owned energy providers, but it is, I think, unnecessary for it to be illegal, effectively, for public bodies to work together in this way.
And you mentioned the police and the NHS as being possible partners very nearby that could take part in this. Would that mean potential cost savings for them, and therefore, you know, following that through, things like more bobbies on the beats, more nurses and so forth? Is this worth pursuing because money is available that could be saved?
Well, that is one of the main points of this whole idea, in order to minimise the cost to public bodies of things like electricity and heating, and to maximise the amount of scarce resource that is available to provide essential public services to people. So that's exactly what it is about, and I would have hoped that here, given the difficulties that are being caused to across the European Union by the public finances, that this is something that ought to be reopened and ought to be reconsidered with a view to allowing exactly that, public bodies to save money and therefore to continue to be able to provide and improve public services, essential public services.
And just finally, what kind of impact would it have on the scheme if you can't get the EU to change its mind or to adapt the rules? What kind of impact could that have on Aberdeen Heat and Power and its ability to continue viable as a viable entity?
Well, I think this is about a frustration rather than a viability. The scheme is working, it's operating, and it just seems to be common sense that neighbouring closely neighbouring public authorities ought to be able to work together in an initiative like this, whereas the strict application of the rules at the moment would mean that it would be perfectly all right for the health service in the Grampian area, including Aberdeen, to set up an identical project and therefore duplicating costs, but it's not all right for them to work with the City Council to do exactly the same job. So I think it's an element of a technicality that it is not necessary and it's causing some considerable frustration, and I think rightly so.
I mean, you say considerable frustration. Is it your view that the current rules are rather crazy as they stand because of these technical barriers standing in the way?
Well, I think it could be said that this is a daft regulation that is being applied over strictly, but this is how the current procurement rules are actually drafted and unfortunately have been the subject of a judgment on a related issue in Italy, I believe. So we need, I think, an open mind on the part of the Commission and others around here to have a look at the implications of that judgment and to have a balance put against that while reviewing the regulation and weighing up alongside that the need to conserve public resources and get better value and provide better public services for people, which is really what's at the core of this question.